Hello, everybody. I appreciate you guys always joining me when I do these live videos. Tonight, I'm going to show you how to make smoky applewood pork, skinny mac and cheese, and Parmesan garlic bread. So like Parmesan garlic bread. It's really easy. We're just going to use a loaf of French bread for that. You guys are going to love these recipes. They're really quick, really easy. And I actually brought a second microwave in here so that I could do these two simultaneously and make this video go just a little bit quicker for you guys tonight. Both of these recipes have a little bit of a cook time. So hopefully I've planned this well and we won't end up with any dead time while we're just waiting on the microwave. If we do, then I can always finish offline and show you the pictures when I'm done. So the first recipe that we're going to start off with is going to be the smoky applewood pork. And we are going to make that in our everyday pan. This is the Rock Crock everyday pan, and it is a 2.5 quart size. We have 5 different sizes. We have a 2 quart casserole, the 2.5 quart everyday pan. We have a 4 quart Dutch oven Rock Crock, which we're going to make our mac and cheese in just a little while. We also have an 8 quart Dutch oven Rock Crock, and we have a Rock Crock pizza stone. So many different Rock Crocks to choose from. My favorite and the most popular is the 4 quart Dutch oven, which we're going to make the macaroni and cheese in. So you'll see that one in just a few minutes. But we're going to start off with the smoky applewood pork. Now, if you don't have a Rock Crock, you've got to add at least one to your kitchen, because you truly can cook anything and everything that you want in a Rock Crock. If you cook it on the stovetop or the oven, in the microwave, on a grill, a smoker, it really doesn't matter where you like to cook the most. You can make it in a Rock Crock in all of those places. This also goes in the dishwasher for really easy cleanup. So definitely get the 4 quart Dutch oven to start with. This is the 2.5 quart everyday pan. The recipe that I'm going to make in this pan tonight can be made in the 4 quart Dutch oven. In fact, if you get the 4 quart size, you can make any recipe for the 3 smallest sizes. So it's really the best value and the most versatile piece. So the Rock Crocks are made of clay. They're coated in ceramic. The ceramic coating gives you the ability to cook with these on the stovetop and everywhere else that I mentioned earlier. We're going to cook everything in the microwave tonight. We're going to start off with a pork tenderloin. And I have this in one of our leak-proof storage containers. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you guys can start to see what I'm doing here a little bit better. I've got about 1.5 pounds. Typically the recipe calls for about 2 pounds, but I'm using a smaller one tonight since obviously there's no audience here to eat this. My family will eat this for dinner tomorrow. So I've got about 1.5 pound pork tenderloin in here, and all that I've done so far is I've just trimmed this up. So I removed the fat and removed the silver skin that is on the outside. There. We're going to add some of our smoky applewood pork, smoky applewood rub on top of the pork. I'm going to do a really nice thick coating, probably about 2 tablespoons. Don't be afraid to use a lot of seasoning when you're cooking. If you don't know this already, all of our dry rubs and seasonings are gluten-free. So if you are on a gluten-free diet, you're going to love the gluten-free seasonings that we have available to you. We also have a gluten-free pizza crust, beer bread mix, as well as a flour mix. So definitely check those out on my website. I'll post that in the comments when the video is completed. I also have a recipe group here on Facebook. You can find it by searching my name, adding a hyphen, and the words Pampered Chef. So right now, this is all that I've done so far. I have the pork tenderloin in here with about 2 tablespoons, a rough estimate there, of the smoky applewood rub. We're gonna add an onion, an apple, and a sweet potato to this. So let's start off with the onion. I'm going to use our veggie wedger for this. I went ahead and peeled the onion before I started. This is the veggie wedger. You just take your peeled onion and you're going to place it right here on the base. The really cool thing about this is that you can use it for a variety of different fruits and vegetables. You can use it on fruits and vegetables that don't have a core. So onions, potatoes, sweet potatoes, tomatoes, citrus fruit. So we just have the peeled onion. You're going to put the wedger on the top and you just press straight down and you're able to wedge that. I'm just going to toss this right inside of the, my mind is not coming up with these, the Rock Crock right now. So this is the 2.5 quart size. We're going to take our serrated peeler. It looks very similar to the julienne peeler, but the blade is a little bit different. The really cool thing about the serrated peeler is that you can use it on other foods that you wouldn't think to use a regular vegetable peeler on. So for example, you can use this on peaches, you can use it on kiwi fruit, but you can also use it on everything that you normally peel with a regular vegetable peeler. So your potatoes, your carrots, anything else that you want to peel. So we're just going to peel this. You can do this with a peel on if you wanted to. I've done it both ways, so I'm not going to worry about this flat piece right here that's going to be a little bit difficult to shred or to peel. I'm going to take one of our sharp knives here. This is the color-coded chef's knife. I'm going to take half of the sweet potato and put it right there. Now with the sweet potato, I cut it in half because it's going to be harder to do this with, but it's very cool that you can wedge your potatoes. So you got to work a little bit harder on the sweet potatoes. I'm going to put a flat edge on there. That's why you want to cut it in half. And you're kind of rocking this back and forth like that. Toss this in. Now we're going to take an apple. You can use any variety apple that you want. I'm going to take our apple wedger. You're just going to line up the hole to the core here. Press straight down, and it's going to separate that, and it cores it at the same time. So you're going to want to peel these apple wedges from the top. Don't go from the bottom because it's really sharp, and I don't want you guys to cut yourself. And then I just push the core back out for easy cleanup. All right, so I'm going to set this cutting board aside, and we're going to get this put in the microwave. So let me show you what this looks like. We're not using any liquid. So we've got the pork, the onions, the apples, and the sweet potato. Put the lid on here, microwave this for about 20 minutes. So that's the really cool thing about using this in the microwave is you're going to be getting like crock pot results in 30 minutes or less instead of waiting all day long for something to cook in your crock pot. So let me put this in the microwave. All right, the next recipe that we're going to make is the skinny mac and cheese. So what we're going to do with this, I've taken the 4-quart Dutch oven and I've already riced almost an entire head of cauliflower in here. You can buy this, of course, at a lot of the grocery stores, but it's a little bit more expensive than buying the cauliflower in the head and ricing it yourself. So we're going to rice this with our our veggie strip maker. I like this because you can use it on a variety of different foods. You can grate just about any vegetable that you want. You can use it for eggplant, your squash, zucchini, cucumbers, carrots. You can also use it to grate an apple if you wanted to do that. One of the really popular recipes that I make in this rock crock is going to be a carrot apple spice cake. You basically mix a spice cake according to the package directions. You're going to put this right on the top of the crock and you're going to shred 4 carrots and 1 apple, then mix it into the batter, put the lid on here, and then put it in the microwave. So I'm just going to attach the veggie strip maker. You can see how it just kind of attaches to the top. And I saved a little piece of the cauliflower here. So all I'm going to do is just rub this back and forth to rice this. So I did tell you guys I'm making mac and cheese, so if you're a little bit confused, we are making this with cauliflower, and my husband took the kids to dinner, so I'm really hoping that they're not watching this right now because they don't know that I put cauliflower in our macaroni and cheese. So we're going to grate this whole head of cauliflower, pop it in the rock crock here. This is a dishwasher safe product as well. We're going to add just a few ingredients to this before we put this in the microwave. So I want to show you our prep bowls. We have 3 different size prep bowls. We have, I'm going to widen this just a little bit. So we have the 1 cup, the 2 cup, and the 3 cup size bowls. They're glass bowls. They have plastic lids. They nest together for easy storage. And the bowls are microwave, oven, and dishwasher safe. Of course, you can use them in the fridge or the freezer. The small set, which is the 1 cup size, you get 6 bowls and 6 lids. These 2 sizes, you're going to get 2 bowls and 2 lids with each of those sets. So you have 3 different sizes, and if you're familiar with our batter bowls, I've been using the classic bowl, but this is the small batter bowl. We're going to use this one here in just a few minutes. So let's go ahead and add our ingredients in here. So we've got 2 cups of uncooked macaroni. So this is so that your family still thinks it's macaroni. It's going to look like macaroni. Pour that in there. And then we're going to add a little bit of garlic. I'm going to set this aside for just a second because I want to show you our garlic peeler. So I have some garlic in here. We're going to take a couple of cloves. Pop this off. Maybe. Well, that one doesn't want to get sliced. Okay. So 2 cloves of garlic. I'm going to take the garlic peeler. This is just a little silicone tube. You're going to take your garlic clove, pop it right inside, press down, and just roll. What this does is it just rubs the paper skin right off of the garlic. So you don't have to get it under your fingernails, so you can see how it's, let's see if we can get all that out so you can see. And then there's gonna be more on the inside. You can just rinse this off, throw it in the dishwasher when you're done. We're gonna take these two peeled cloves, we're gonna put them right inside of this garlic slicer. There's a little divider in there, so I'm gonna put one on each side. Move our crock back over here. You're gonna take this piece, which is like a little plunger tool, you put it right on the inside here, press it, and while you're twisting, let me get this started and then you guys can see. Let me zoom in a little bit. So you've got these really cool slices of garlic. If you don't know this already, the smaller the piece of garlic, the more intense the flavor. So if you're pressing garlic with your garlic press, then you're gonna have a really strong flavor of garlic. But if you slice the garlic with the garlic slicer, you're gonna get these really paper thin slices. So it's gonna be a really mild flavor. Basically, we wanna cover up the cauliflower taste in this recipe, and the garlic is gonna help do that. We're gonna take some salt and pepper. This is our new salt and pepper grinder set. I love this. It's really easy to fill. You unscrew the tops and you just pour the peppercorn medley that we sell in the Himalayan sea salt in the other. So I'm gonna hold this over our crock and you're just gonna twist, add some pepper, add some salt, and then we're gonna mix together a few liquid ingredients to pour over this. We're gonna use the small batter bowl. We've got a half a cup of our milk measured out in our Easy Read measuring cup. These measuring cups are great because instead of looking through the side of the cup to know how much you're measuring, you're just gonna look directly into the cup. So the liquid rises on a slant in front of you, so you're not bending down and looking through the side. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a half a cup of milk in here. Then I'm gonna take our can opener and open a can of chicken broth. This is our smooth edge can opener. The smooth edge can opener is gonna leave a smooth edge on the lid and on the can. The really cool thing about this is you're not gonna have to worry about cutting yourself after you take the lid off. I like to start at the front of the can so that I know when I've gone all the way around. So I'm gonna turn this around. You just attach the can opener like this, give it a turn, and it attaches itself to the can. So you can see my starting point there. You're gonna turn until you bypass your starting point. And then you're gonna turn counterclockwise, just like this. Releases the can. There is a button on the side right here. So this button is gonna activate a little pincher claw on the other side. So you just pinch the lid, pull it off, and then there is no jagged edge on the lid or on the can. I'm actually gonna measure out 1.5 cups of this. It's just slightly less than a full can. Let's see. I see some comments coming up on my new app that I use to give you guys a better look. The comments are a lot smaller, so y'all bear with me. I will definitely answer any comments. If you're having questions, I'll answer those afterwards. If you're just telling me something great, I can't wait to read them. If you haven't already done this, if you would look in the bottom corners of your screen, there's a like button in one corner and a share button in the other. If you would like this video and then share it and tag me in your post, I would really appreciate it. I would love to get more people watching these videos and sharing these great recipes. All right, in this leak-proof container, this is our 1.5 cup size, I have some flour. These containers are great to store anything. They're not just for storing leftovers in the fridge. You can use them for anything that you want, on the counter, in the pantry, in the freezer, in the fridge, wherever you want. So I have some flour in this one, and I'm gonna use one of our measuring spoons that comes with our measuring spoon set. This is the tablespoon measurement. I'm gonna measure out 2 tablespoons of flour. And then I'm gonna take our stainless whisk. This is the large whisk, but we also sell a small one. I'm gonna whisk this together really nicely so we don't have any lumps in that flour. And again, this is the small batter bowl. So this is a 4 cup capacity size. We also have an 8 cup. I've had this whisk, you guys, for probably 14 or 15 years. I can't remember what year Pampered Chef restyled it. It has a solid stainless steel handle, so nothing is gonna get stuck inside of the handle. It's never gonna rust. It's dishwasher safe. It's just such a great whisk. We're gonna pour this liquid mixture in here. And I'm gonna take one of our bamboo spoons to stir this. Now, if you're interested in getting a rock crock, I have a really great deal for you guys tonight. Typically, this is something that I only offer at a party, but I'm offering it for anybody that's watching, whether you're already on my contact list or if somebody shared this video with you, then you're able to get this deal as well. You just have to contact me through Facebook to get this special offer. Basically, what I'm offering tonight is the 4-quart Dutch oven along with the veggie strip maker. So this is what I use to rice the cauliflower. You're also going to get a recipe card set that goes along with this crock. Plus, I'll include 3 bamboo spoon sets, and I'll give you access to a downloadable cookbook that has over 100 recipes. You can make all 100 recipes right here in this crock. This is going to go in the microwave for about 17 minutes, so it's really, really a relatively quick recipe, but since we're live, I'm going to go ahead and put it in there, and I'll come back and tell you how you can take advantage of that deal. Okay, so if you're interested in taking advantage of the rock crock special that I'm offering tonight, then all you have to do is contact me on Facebook, send me a message, and say, hey, I want the video special that you offered tonight. It's $159. You're going to get discount shipping, just $5 to ship it to you. If you live in Alaska or Hawaii, it'll be $10 to ship it. You can share this video. As many people that want to take advantage of this deal can. You'll also get to choose a free gift, and I'll make sure to give you your options when I get your order. So definitely let me know if you have any questions about the special or if it's something that you're interested in. Now, we are going to make another recipe while we wait on the pork. We have about 10 minutes left on our pork tenderloin. I'm going to tell you about these really cool cleaning cloths here. If you don't have these in your kitchen yet, you definitely want to get these. These are amazing. They come as a set of 3. You get 2 of these green ones and you get a larger blue one. They come to you dry, but when you wet them, they get really soft. You can use them to clean pretty much anything that you want in your kitchen or your home. They're great for stainless steel appliances. They're great for countertops. You can clean and wash your dishes with them. My favorite thing about this is they go right in the dishwasher for easy cleanup. So if you're like I used to be, all of my washcloths and sponges, they ended up in the laundry upstairs and then they never made their way back down here. And I never had that when I needed it. And so I like that I can just toss this right in the dishwasher anytime that I clean it. Clean the dishes, and this comes out nice and clean, and it doesn't ever smell and doesn't get gross. So if you're interested in these, you get 3 of them for $8.50. I'm offering a special discount on shipping. You can get the set for $10 total, so that'll ship direct to you for just $10, 3 cloths, and shipping for $10. All right, the next recipe that we're going to make is going to be made on one of our new stoneware entertaining platters. Now I have 2 sizes. This is the large one. I absolutely love this. I use this a lot over Christmas for cookies. This will fit in your oven. You can fit 2 of the large ones side by side, just set them right inside of the oven. So you can do 2 pans of cookies at a time. This is the same size as our large bar pan. So those of you that are bar pan lovers, you're gonna love this because it's so much prettier. You can serve up really nice dishes that look great and taste great right on our entertaining platter. So it's stoneware, but it's completely glazed. So it's sandstone on the bottom and it's gray stone on the top. So I love this. So we're gonna basically take a loaf of French bread. There's so many different varieties of French bread out there. This is the one that I chose. This is one that's like partially baked, I guess, but we'll fully bake it when you finish up. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna first set this aside. This is the medium size. I've kind of been using this just as like a tray for my scraps and dirty dishes. I'll set that aside. We're gonna take this loaf of bread, and we're gonna use one of our bread knives. We have a couple of different bread knives. We have forged cutlery and we have some of our color-coded knives. I'm gonna be using the color-coded knives tonight. So we're just gonna take this out, take one of our color-coded knives, and I'm just gonna start slicing. So I'll give you guys a closer view here so you can see this knife up close. I'm actually gonna try something different with this. Obviously we're not eating this tonight. This is our dinner for tomorrow night, but we also aren't usually going to eat a whole loaf of bread at one time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm only gonna slice half of this and then I can refreeze the other half. But I'm also gonna try to freeze these bread slices. Whoops, I don't wanna go in there, I'll worry about that later. I'm gonna freeze the uncooked bread with the butter spread on them and see how they do. We're gonna try like taking just a couple out at a time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna transfer these over to this entertaining platter. If you slice the whole the whole loaf of bread, then you'd be able to fit pretty much all of it right here on this. You can kind of squish them together. I don't need that much space tonight, but we're going to butter these with one stick of butter. I have that in our 3-cup prep bowl right here. So I've had this has had time to get soft. We're going to use our Parmesan garlic oil dipping seasoning. So if you're not familiar with the oil dipping seasonings, these are great because you can just pour them right into a little dish or on a plate and add olive oil or melted butter. My preference is butter. You can melt the butter or pour the olive oil right on top of it, and then you can dip your bread like if you go to Carrabba's or some of the other Italian restaurants that are out there. Like I mentioned earlier, all of our dry rubs and seasonings are gluten-free. So we're gonna add 1 teaspoon of the Parmesan garlic oil dipping seasoning. Don't let the name fool you. You can use this on chicken and vegetables, fish, anything that you want to use it on. You can even put it on popcorn. Whatever you want to use it on is fine. I'm going to take our all-purpose spreader. I'm going to mix this together. So this is just 1 stick of butter that I had softened. Just let it sit on the counter for a little while. 1 teaspoon of the Parmesan garlic seasoning. You can add more if you want, but I think you'll be really surprised how much flavor you're gonna get from 1 teaspoon of this seasoning. Mix this really good. We have about 5 more minutes on the pork. You guys are gonna be amazed when you see this, by the way. All right, so we're just gonna take our spreader and I'm gonna spread the butter on here. You're gonna bake this at 350 for about 12 to 15 minutes. Every oven is just slightly different, but I usually cook mine for about 15 minutes. Whoops. Get this little guy back over here. And remember, if you have any questions, feel free to type those in the comments. And when the video is over, I will come back and answer all of your questions. I am going to be doing a training tonight, so if I don't get right back to you, then you will know that I will get back to you before the night is over. If you're doing a full loaf of bread, then you'll be able to use all of this butter. I'm going to put that in the fridge because we can use that in the meantime on other things. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this in my deep freezer for just a little while, right on the stone. Once they've had a chance to just set up a little bit so the butter is not really sticky, then I'm going to transfer these just the way that they are right into like a Ziploc bag, freeze them, and then I'm going to see how it works just doing these as we want them. So stay tuned for more details about that. All right, while we're waiting on the pork to finish, I'm going to clean off my cutting board there. We're going to go ahead and shred some cheese because with our mac and cheese, we are going to need to add in 8 ounces of shredded cheddar cheese and about 10 ounces of Greek yogurt. So you remember I told you this is called skinny mac and cheese because we used a whole head of cauliflower, just a little bit of pasta. We added some chicken broth, some milk, and some flour, microwaving that for 17 minutes. Then we're going to stir in the Greek yogurt and the shredded cheese. This is about 10 ounces of Greek yogurt, so I'm just gonna mix all of it in the mac and cheese when we're done, just because I don't need 2 ounces of Greek yogurt laying around. So we're gonna take our cheese, and if you've watched any of my videos, and I know you've already heard the spiel about the reason that you wanna buy your cheese in a block and shred it yourself, but you're gonna hear it again, because I'm sure there's some people watching who've never heard this before. We're gonna use the Microplane coarse grater. I just slid our food holder on there. You're gonna take your block of cheese, put it right in there, and then this piece has 3 prongs, so you're just gonna kind of pierce that block of cheese like this. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna start over here. It's really easy to shred this cheese. And a lot of times you do end up with this little sliver. You can just eat that as your snack. We're gonna do the other half. So the reason you wanna buy your cheese in a block and shred it yourself is because when you buy it in a bag, it's going to have cellulose powder added into that. And if you don't know what cellulose powder is, that is a fancy name for ground up wood fibers, which is sawdust. And that sawdust keeps the cheese from sticking together, but unfortunately, it also keeps it from melting very well. Now, this cheese grater is dishwasher safe, so you just throw it on the top rack of the dishwasher. It's real easy to clean up. Then, you take your flexible cutting mat. We're just gonna funnel this cheese right back into our 3-cup square. Now, I'm not really worried about these 2 slivers of cheese because these are gonna melt when I stir them in the mac and cheese. But if you're shredding the cheese to use later, what you can do is shred the whole block of cheese, put it in the 3-cup container. What you're gonna do is just snap the lids down. The flaps down on the lid, and then put it in the refrigerator. Now, this is gonna stay fresh for weeks at a time if it lasts that long at your house. At my house, the cheese doesn't last that long. We went through a block yesterday, and we used some more this morning when we cooked some eggs with some shredded cheese. So we go through a lot of cheese over here. But this 3-cup square will hold an 8-ounce block. The 5 1/4-cup square will hold a 16-ounce block. And then, of course, the 8 1/4-cup will hold even more than that. So when the mac and cheese is done, we are going to stir in the Greek yogurt and the shredded cheese. I'm going to move this cutting mat out of the way because our pork is almost done. When this comes out of the microwave, what we're going to do is we're going to take our salad choppers. These salad choppers are double-bladed scissors. If you've never used these, this is my number 2 favorite product from Pampered Chef. So number 1 absolutely is the Rock Crocs. Number 2 is the salad choppers. So I have 4-year-old twins. I don't have to cut up their food nearly as much as I used to. But when they were babies, I had to cut everything up. And when they were toddlers, of course, I was using these. We have 3 of these in our house. Almost every single day, all 3 of them end up in the dishwasher. We use these for everything. You can chop cooked chicken. You can slice a pork tenderloin, which we're going to do here in just a few minutes. If you're making barbecue sandwiches, you could then take the slices and chop all of the slices up as well. You can use this for all of your salad ingredients. So occasionally I'll find myself in a Chick-fil-A drive-thru, and if I still want to try to eat healthy, then I'll get a salad, bring it home, and I'll put it in one of our, usually I put it in this bowl here. This is the small batter bowl. You could use this one or the 2-quart size. Dump your salad in here and then take your salad choppers. And what you're going to do is you're just going to chop, 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 chop. Everything is going to be the same size. You can also use this on fruits and vegetables. Both cooked and raw vegetables work great. Let me grab our pork out of the microwave. Okay, we have 6 minutes left on the mac and cheese, so I think I timed this pretty well. So this is our pork. Sometimes it can take 25 minutes, but because I was using a smaller pork tenderloin, I think we should be good to go. So you can take a thermometer, which I didn't get out. Whoops. And I'm just going to cut in the middle of this and just double check it. No, that microwave cooked slower than my other one. That was a microwave I had in the basement, but I can still go ahead and show you this, and then we can chop it up after we finish the mac and cheese. So hopefully you guys can see how pretty this is. I would love for you guys to see all of the juices in here, because remember, we didn't put any liquid. This pan's a little bit hot. I probably should be using some oven pads here. So I don't know if you guys can see that in the camera, but there are cooked sweet potatoes, apples, and onions, and there's so much broth in the bottom here. I'm gonna pop this back in the microwave. I'm gonna put it in there for 5 minutes. And using our oven mitts here. All right, so when that's done, I'm actually gonna grab a clean pair of salad choppers and we will chop that up. Then what I would do normally is I would transfer those sliced pork pieces to one of our entertaining platters, like we have the bread on there, and then you can take the sweet potatoes and the onions and the apples out, and it really makes a great little side dish to serve along with the mac and cheese and the pork. So I'm going to grab my phone and see if anybody had any questions while we're waiting on this to finish up, and then I can answer those questions for you. Remember to like and share this video. I would really appreciate it if you guys would do that for me. Let's see what questions we have. If you have a question, go ahead and comment it here. I'm turn my volume down so I don't have to hear myself talking. All right, let's see here. Hey, Lily. Hey, Pam. Hey, Amy. Sarah, hello. Hey, Ashley. You're so sweet. Oh, no, Tiffany. I'm so sorry. Yes, you need to. I'm assuming you're talking about the cheese grater, Tiffany, so I can certainly help you order that. There's a teacher at your school that just did a party with me last Thursday. We could add it on there if you want to. We're going to be closing that out tonight. Hey, Samantha. Fried rice sounds delicious. LaShawn, I know you know how good this skinny mac and cheese is because we made that at your party. So let's see. Lindsay, you are going to totally need those salad choppers with that cute little boy. Lily, the cleaning cloths come 3 to a pack. Thanks. Somebody just answered that question. I can't. Ashley, thank you. I saw you pop up. It was slower than on my phone. So if you guys have any other questions, just let me know. I'll be happy to answer those for you. Just to remind you guys, when we get that mac and cheese out, we're going to stir in the Greek yogurt. And like I said, the recipe calls for about 8 ounces. We're going to put 10 ounces in because these come in smaller containers. Of course, if you have the a large container already in your refrigerator, then you can certainly just use that. The mac and cheese has just a couple minutes left. These are our oven mitts. I'm going to go ahead and grab that out a little bit early. It probably is already done. If you've never used these before, these are great. They're great for indoors and outdoors. Keith has his own set of these oven mitts for his Big Green Egg. A lot of times people will ask me at my parties if these are big enough for their husband's hands. And my husband loves them. They are great to use on the grill or on a smoker. So let me go ahead and grab our mac and cheese. Hopefully it is done. And then we can finish up the pork here in just a second. Okay, so you definitely want to use the lid. Let me show you. So the cauliflower kind of pops around and jumps around in there. So you definitely want to use the lid so you don't make a mess in your microwave, okay? So let me set this over here. And I'll tilt this up so you guys can see what it looks like on the inside. So we've got our cooked cauliflower and our noodles. Take one of our bamboo spoons. It's looking good. Give this a quick stir. The pasta looks like it's fully cooked, so I'm gonna just transfer the cheese in here. Mix this up, and then we'll stir in the Greek yogurt. Hopefully the pork will be done. This is the first time that I've used that microwave for cooking. I've used it for reheating. It's a microwave I got free from Pampered Chef a few years ago, and it's been in my basement. I use it occasionally down there, but haven't done much cooking in there. Now make sure you're using plain Greek yogurt. It's really easy to pick up vanilla instead of plain. Wouldn't add the same flavor if you used vanilla. All right, now if you don't know this about the rock crocs, they retain heat for a really extended period of time. And so this mac and cheese will actually stay warm for a while. This is such a great recipe. So I hope you guys will try it. A little bit later on tonight when I finish up this training that I'm going to do for my team, I will be happy to post the recipe so that you guys can check it out and make it yourself. If you're already on my Pampered Chef recipe group, it's already posted there several times. So here's our delicious mac and cheese. If you want to get the recipe right away, go to my recipe group on Facebook, which is my name, Mindy Muscle Banks, add a hyphen and the words Pampered Chef. Join the group and you can do a search right on your iPhone or your smartphone. Also on your desktop, there's a little search button. Search for mac and cheese or skinny mac and cheese and you'll be able to get that recipe. So I'm going to set this aside. So, I said I was going to get some clean salad choppers. Let me grab another pair. All right. Let's see what we're working with now. Perfect. Okay. So, basically, I want you guys to get a really good close-up view of this. So, what I'm going to do is sorry to cut that piece off, but typically I start at one end. You're going to press all the way down to the bottom of the pan and slice. And so you're going to get these really beautiful slices. So I'm just going to slice the pork, and then we'll take this out and put it on a serving platter. Now, I do recommend that you let your food rest, your meat rest, for just a few minutes because all of those juices will redistribute. So I'm going to let that rest for a few minutes before I finish that up. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this video tonight. If you have any questions, like I said, just put them in the comments. I'll check this one more time before I leave and see if you guys have any questions. Hey there, Kayla. I'm so glad that you joined. Kiss Charlie for me, please. Ashley, there's really not necessarily a benefit as far as in the rock crock or a pan using bamboo over the metal or plastic. You can use metal spoons and knives and all of that right in the rock crocks. it's just a personal choice, really. I use the bamboo spoons and our silicone scrapers pretty much the same amount. So whatever you want to use in your kitchen, then you go right for it. It's going to be great. So if you guys have any questions, like I said, just feel free to comment. I'll answer those a little bit later on tonight if I don't get to it before I start my training. I appreciate you joining me. All of these recipes, the bread, the pork, and the mac and cheese are in the recipe group. So again, to find that recipe group on Facebook, just type my name, Mindy Musselbanks, add a hyphen, and the words Pampered Chef. Join the group and then search for smoky applewood pork, skinny mac and cheese, and then the garlic bread. So I hope you guys have a wonderful night, and I look forward to coming back with another recipe maybe this week one day. So y'all have a great night, okay? Take care.